Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and in this video we're going to be doing another cartel market highlight, this time of the Executioner's War Staff, which was released as a platinum rarity item, costs, you know, 3,000 something cartel coins, but actually sells for an extremely low price on the GTN. I've seen it on all three of the major servers for anywhere from 3 to 5 million credits, which is extremely low, especially for a platinum rarity item. And while its low price might speak to its popularity, meaning it's not that popular among people, and I think you can see why. Aesthetically, it's not the nicest looking weapon. It's very bulky, doesn't have a lot of cool stuff associated with it. But you might be interested to know that there's actually a really unique property about this weapon that sets it apart from every single other weapon in the game. This is indeed a very unique weapon that can actually have a very unique visual effect associated with it, and that is because the Executioner's War Staff, while it doesn't have an actual blade, rather it has an opening among in between the two jaws of the weapon. I'm just gonna call it that because that's really what it looks like. What's interesting about it though is when you apply a weapon tuning to the staff, the weapon tuning assumes that there is a blade in between the middle, and I'll show you what that looks like on the screen right now with a variety of weapon tunings. I'm just basically running through each of them, but you can see with things like the lightning weapon tuning or the volatile weapon tuning, it's kind of just a big effect that's happening in the middle of the weapon, although there's really nothing but empty space there. And what makes that so unique is that applying the weapon tuning really gives you an aesthetic visual effect that you will not find on any other weapon. On none of the other weapons can you have just the tuning effect happen in open space. And to really highlight this, I'll show you this with the Ode Benar weapon tuning, which is the one from the Osus, and it's actually, a really cheap weapon tuning on the GTN, or you can actually find it in-game by doing the quest on Osus. But basically, the normal effect of the weapon tuning is that it causes these vines to kind of grow on the hilt of your saber as well as the actual blade, and same thing on the blaster rifles and stuff. But because there is nothing but open space in the middle of the Executioner's War Staff, this will actually cause the vines to grow on nothing, but they will grow into the air. And I'll show you exactly what that looks like on screen. And it's really cool, and I'll also show you that when you sheath and then unsheath your weapon, the vines will actually grow each time as if it's kind of like some sort of wooden staff. Now you can decide whether this is something that looks nice or something you would be interested in using. The overall loadout, meaning what it would cost to kind of create this item, is really cheap actually. You can buy the war staff for anywhere from, like, let's say 4 million, 5 million credits. Maybe if you're unlucky, you'll find it at a higher price at around 8 million, but the tuning only costs like 1 million, sometimes under a million credits. So overall, under 10 million credits for this really unique aesthetic effect, if it appeals to you, I think is quite reasonable. And even if you don't think it looks very good, nonetheless, you have to agree that this is a really unique thing, and it's only something that I found with the Executioner's War Staff. I have kind of experimented with some of the other staffs, the other electro staffs, vibro blades, all of that kind of stuff, and I just haven't been able to create anything quite as unique as this. In any case, I hope you enjoyed this short cartel market highlight. Let me know in the comment section if you have found any weapon that's similar to this, or if you have your own kind of cool combination of weapon tunings with weapons. I'd be interested in hearing what you guys have to say. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one.